I have two slightly related questions. Well, I guess the first one is, we were talking about how, well, this could be the resurgence of religion is, could be the last gasp of religion, and I was wondering what exactly are the proofs or justifications of that, especially when we were also talking about how, because of globalization, people are looking back to religion and relying more and more on it. And then I guess I'll pose my other question later.
So what are some of the indicators? Well, I mean, you can take if Europe is paradigmatic. What's going to happen as countries develop, as nations develop in the course of globalization processes? Well, then you look at Sweden. I think the church attendance is about 2 to 3%. You look in at Great Britain. I think church attendance is there somewhere around 5 or so. Percent, and you can go down the line, and it's not just true of the Protestant nations, it's also true of the Catholic ones. In Italy, it's dropping rapidly. In Spain, it's dropping rapidly. These countries are secularizing, and the theory then was, this is really what happens when you give modernization a chance, right? Just let it sit for a while. And have its impact. It's going to erode religious convictions. That's often paired with the idea of what function it is that religion fulfills, right? And the claim that these functions that religion in primitive societies for primitive people fulfills will be fulfilled. We can show how they will be fulfilled by other. By forces of modernization, easy access to medicine, social care, and so forth and so forth, and you will basically not need religion. So you have an account of how societies develop and what is it that creates the need for religion, and you say, well, it's most likely that's exactly what's going to happen in other countries as well. So that's, I think, roughly, and sociologists of religion, great sociologists have believed this for roughly 200 years, you know. So we are now realizing that that might not be the case, and only recently we have these theories of multiple modernities studying very carefully how different societies modernize and what happens with them when they modernize. The United States was seen as always as an anomaly and it needed some explaining, and explanations were offered, but Europe was paradigm. Now it's inverted. Now United States is seen more like as a paradigm, and Europe, for whatever reason, is seen to be anomalous in terms of developments, because we see analogous things happening in other countries as we see in United States. Now, that's on this side, right? On the side of advocate of multiple modernity. Others will say, well, even the United States, just give it a time. It's going to go down. And some indicators are there that religious observance, for whatever reason, is overreported in the United States, that the United States is much less religious of a country than it's claimed than it is, and so forth. So the debate goes back and forth.